Praise the Lord.
Okay, hallelujah.
Everybody praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's pray together. Almighty God, we thank you very much today. We are grateful because you have gathered us together. We are praying, O Lord, you will bless all your people here tonight in Jesus' name. We pray that everyone will receive a miraculous touch. And nobody will go back the same in Jesus' name. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Tonight I'm talking on an important subject. We're talking about the unchanging Christ.
I'm sorry, Christi ti ko le yi pada.
The unchanging Christ.
Christi ti ko le yi pada.
The life and the ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ is summarized for us in Hebrews chapter 13 verse 8.
Igbe aye ati ise iranse Jesu Christi Oluwa ni a se akojopo akekuru re fun wa ninu Hebrews ori katale ese kejo.
It treats like this: Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever.
O ka bayi pe Jesu Christi okana ni ni ana ati ni oni ati titi lai.
The life and the accounts of his ministry were recorded in Matthew, Mark, Luke and John.
Akosile nipa igbe aye ati ise iranse re ni akosile fun wa ninu irere ti Matthew, ti Mark, ti Luke ati ti John.
And we see all that record telling us about the love of Christ.
Gbogbo akosile yi la ri to nso fun wa nipa ife Christi.
About the compassion of Christ.
Nipa ikaanu Christi.
About the mercy of Christ.
Nipa anu Christi.
About the power and might of Christ.
Nipa agbara ati ipa Christi.
And about the teaching of Christ.
Ati nipa ikoni Christi.
The passage I read to you says Christ cannot change, has not changed, will never change.
Ibi ti mo ka se ti gbo ore yi fi wa lokan bale wi pe Christi ko ti yipada ko le yipada ko si ni yipada.
He himself promises us that he will be with us till the end of the world in the same love and power.
O fura re lo seleri fun wa wi pe ohun yo ma wa pelu wa nigba gbogbo ti jo video pe aye ninu agbara ti
ipere. There is nothing that changes about Christ.
Ko si ohun ko ti o ma yipada nipa Christi.
There are just three things I'm looking at today.
O meta pere na ni mo n gbe yawo loni.
And these three things you will find.
Awon nkan meta yi lo si ri.
They are for your benefit.
Ti won wa fun anfani re.
And as you realize.
Bi o si tin se awari
eyi. That Jesus is unchanging.
Pe Jesu ki yipada.
And these three things we are going to mention.
Awon meta ti a o si menu bayi.
Look at it in your life. And you will see that Christ remains unchanging. Number one, his ministry of miracles. We have the record in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. All these four gospels tell us that Jesus Christ had a ministry of miracles.
Jesu Christi nise iranse kan.
In Matthew chapter 8 verses 2 and 3.
Ninu Matthew ori kejo ese iketa ati ikerin.
And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou can make me clean.
Lati ese keji si wo adete kan wa o teriba fun wo wi pe Oluwa bi iwo ba fe iwo le so mi di mimo.
And Jesus put forth his hand and he touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean.
Ni ese iketa Jesu si na owo re o fi ba o wi pe mo fe iwo di mimo.
And immediately his leprosy was cleansed.
Loju kana ete re si mo.
Remember what the Lord is telling us today.
Lati ohun ti Oluwa so fun wa loni.
That Christ is unchanging.
Pe Christi ko le yi pada.
Yesterday he cleansed the lepers.
Lana o we adete mo.
Today he is cleansing the lepers.
Loni o we awon adete mo.
Until he will come again, he keeps on cleansing the lepers.
Titi yo fi pada de yo ma we awon adete mo.
In that same chapter 8 reading from verse 6.
Ninu Matthew ori kejo yi kana
Say, Lord, my servant lies at home sick of a palsy grievously tormented. And Jesus says unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof. Speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed. The might and power of Jesus Christ was so great. All he needed to do was speak the word only. The attacks will vanish. Affliction will finish. All the curses and the yoke will vanish away. The centurion recognized that. That's why he said, speak the word only. He had the faith, he had the confidence and the trust in the Lord, my servant shall be healed. In verse 13, we find the fulfillment. And Jesus said unto the centurion, go thy way, as thou hast believed, so be it done unto thee. And the servant was healed in the self same hour. You know what the Bible has said in us? As he healed in those days, he's still healing today. Because he has a ministry of miracles that will never change. As Matthew said it, so Mark confirmed it.
Mark,
in Mark chapter 7 verse 37, and they were beyond measure astonished, saying he has done all things well. That's the testimony of man. Anytime he met any sick fellow, anybody that needed a miracle, the testimony is he has done all things well. Everything in your life will be done well tonight in Jesus' name. Then he says, he maketh both the deaf to hear and the dumb to speak. You see what they are telling us? Both Matthew and Mark.
Matthew and Mark.
Telling us God has not changed. Telling us the mind of Christ has not changed. In Luke chapter 6 verse 17. Luke 6:17. And he came down with them. And he stood in the place, and the company of his disciples, and a great multitude out of all Judea and Jerusalem, and from the sea coast of Tyre and Sidon. Which came to him and to be healed of their diseases. And they that were vexed with unclean spirits, they were healed. All of them were healed when the Lord touched them. Matthew tells us Christ had a ministry of miracles. Mark confirmed it. Christ had a ministry of miracles. Luke tells us that Jesus had a ministry of miracles. And you know what the Lord is telling us? As he was yesterday, so he is today, and so he will ever be. His ministry of miracles is unchanging. In verse 19, it says, the whole multitude sought to touch him, for there went virtue out of him, and he healed them all.
You should
begin to get ready.
Because
the Lord is coming your way tonight. That ministry of miracle has never changed.
He's
still opening the eyes of the blind.
He's
still making the lame to rise and walk.
He's
still cleansing the lepers.
He's
still raising the dead.
He's
still giving children to the barren.
He's
still taking afflictions away. And tonight, he will do it in your life in Jesus' name. In John chapter 7 verse 31. John 7 verse 31. And many of the people believed on him. And they said, when Christ cometh, will he do more miracles than this man has done?
You see what
John is telling
us.
There were so many multiplied miracles that the people began to say, if there is going to be another Christ, will there be more miracles than
these? He's telling
us one
thing.
Christ is a miracle worker.
He
has power to work miracles.
And
that power remains the same today.
He
has done all things well in the past.
He
is doing all things well today.
He's
still performing miracles in the lives of people.
He's
healing the sick.
He's
delivering the oppressed. Tonight, he will touch your life. Tonight, he will do it in your life. You will never be the same in Jesus' name. Immediately, the altar call is given. And you hand over yourself to the Lord. You will find the Lord beginning to work in your life. And then when it comes to time to begin to pray, pray for the people that are sick. Pray for the people that are mental problem. The same thing that Jesus did in the past, he will do in your life today. I said he will do in your life today. Number one then, his ministry of miracles changes not. Number two, the message of the Messiah. What did he say at that time? What did he tell the people at that time? Remember, his ministry has not changed. His message has not changed. His mercy has not changed. His might has not changed. His miracle working power has not changed. His mission has not changed. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Number two then, the message of the Messiah. And that too has not changed. Matthew tells us the message of the Messiah. When we say Messiah, Messiah means Christ. In Matthew chapter 9 verse 13. But go ye and learn what that meaneth. I will have mercy and not sacrifice. For I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance.
Do
you see what the Lord was saying? He was calling sinners to repentance. He knew as you and I know. He knew as all the preachers of the New Testament knew. And he knows today, as your conscience knows, that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But God is willing to forgive. God is willing to pardon. God is willing to blot all your sins away. Yours is a chance tonight that all the sins you ever committed, since you were born, the moment you repent, because that's what he said, The message of the Messiah. And it's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said, I came to call sinners unto repentance. As Matthew said it, Mark affirmed it.
Mark in
Mark chapter 1, verses 14 and 15. Now, after that John was put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. And saying, the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel.
O si wi pe akoko na de ijoba Olorun si ku si dede e ronu piwada ki e si gba yin rere gbo.
Matthew tells us Christ emphasized repentance.
Matthew so fun wa wi pe Christi tenumo ironu piwada.
Mark tells us Jesus emphasized repentance.
Mark pelu tun so fun wa wi pe
what does it mean to repent? It means you feel so sorry for yourself because of what you have done. It means you become so unhappy with the bad evil sins, the sins you have committed. It means you are so sorrowful about it, you turn away from the works of darkness and from all the evil that you have done. You have a right about turn. You say, I leave all that behind. I'm going to go the new way.
In Luke chapter 24, verse 47,
here is what Jesus said, and that repentance and remission of sins shall be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You see what they are telling us? Matthew, Mark, and Luke. They tell us about the message of the Messiah. Every time he came across a sinner, he said, your life is turned upside down.
See,
turns our lives upside down. That we are not the people we ought to be. We have destroyed and defiled ourselves. But he says he can repair everything. He can restructure everything. He can renew everything. He can regenerate everything. He can reform everything. But there is something you have to do. That you will repent. You will turn away from your sin. And Matthew says he's calling sinners to repentance. Mark says, repent ye, believe the gospel. And then Luke tells us that repentance is to be preached in all the world, all the nations. And then we're told in John chapter
8
verse
11,
she said, no man, Lord. Let me tell you the background of the story. A woman had been taken in sin. And there were some Pharisees that came, pointing accusing finger at the woman. And then they wanted to stone the woman. But Jesus said, who of you whosoever does not have any sin, let him cast the first stone. But Jesus knew their hearts. They went away one by one. And then Jesus said, where are the accusers? Has no man been able to condemn you to stone you? And she said, no man, Lord. The Lord does not allow anybody to condemn you. And I am not here to condemn you. I am not here to judge you. I am not here to be negative at your life. I'm only telling you something positive. that Jesus is Savior and Redeemer. And He Himself has not condemned. He is not sitting on the throne of judgment for now. Neither do I condemn you. But then He said, go and sin no more. Telling us the same thing that Matthew, Mark, Luke have told us. Telling us that we need to repent. We were bad, He wants us to be good. We were in darkness, He wants us to be in the light. We were sinful, He wants us to be righteous now. That's why He says, neither do I condemn you. Are you there tonight? Your conscience is telling you you've done something bad. And it is the devil that wants to condemn you. He even wants to say you are too bad. Why don't you commit suicide? That is not the voice of God. The Lord Jesus is telling you tonight. He did not come to condemn. He did not come to judge. He came to save. And He's waiting for you now. If you will only turn from your sin, then He will give you that grace and power to go and sin no more. You know what we're talking about? The unchanging Christ. He has not changed. He loves sinners. He wants to save them. He loves sinners. That's why He's not condemning them. And tonight, He's expecting you will reciprocate that love. You will return that love unto Him. As He gives you the privilege to change from being a sinner, a slave of Satan, to becoming a son of God. You allow Him to do that in your life as you repent. Number one, His ministry of miracles, that ministry has not changed. Number two, His message, the message of the Messiah, has not changed. Number three, His mission among men. His mission among men. By the way, what was the mission of Jesus Christ? That means, what was the thing He came to carry out? Again, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, they tell us. And they are united in telling us of His mission among men. In Matthew chapter 1 verse 21. Matthew chapter 1 verse 21. And she shall be forth a son, and thou shalt call His name Jesus, for He shall save His people from their sins. Didn't you see that? He came to save. That's the very mission of Jesus Christ among men. And tonight, that's what He wants to do. He wants to rescue you. He wants to save you. He wants to bring you to the kingdom of God. He wants to make you a child of God. And He did that because He has died for you on the cross of Calvary. And the angel said, He'll call His name Jehovah Saves Jesus. That means Jehovah saves. Because He, the Christ, will save His people from all their sins. You've been fighting against sin in your life. You've been struggling against sin in your life. You're trying to be the best you could, but you have failed. You cannot save yourself. But Christ is the Savior. The angels announce that Jesus is the Savior. And that's the mission of Jesus Christ among men. Chapter 16, verses 15 and 16. And He said unto them, this Christ talking,
O si wi fun won pe Christi lo nsoro ni.
Go ye into all the world.
E lo si gbogbo aye.
And preach the gospel, the good news to every creature.
Ke si ma wa su yin rere yin ayo fun gbogbo eda.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
Eni ti o ba gbagbo ti a ba si baptize re yo la.
As you believe tonight.
Ti o tin gbagbo lale yi.
You are going to be saved.
I'll go la.
I said you are going to be saved.
I'll go la.
He will forgive your sin.
Yo dari gbogbo esere
jo. He will take you away from the kingdom of darkness.
Yo mu ajade kuro ninu
ijo okoko. He will make you a child of God.
Yo so di omo Olorun.
He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved.
Eni ti o ba gbagbo ti a ba ti baptize re yo la.
He that believeth not shall be damned.
Sugbon eni ti ko ba gbagbo yo jebi.
Matthew tells us the mission of Christ is to save.
Matthew so fun pe ise iranse Christ ni lati
gbagba. Mark tells us the mission of Christ is to save.
Mark pelu kin leyin pe ise Christ ni lati gbagba.
In Luke chapter 9 verse 56.
Ninu Luke ori kesan ese ikere
ni lokota. Luke chapter 9 verse 56.
Luke ori kesan ese ikere ni
lokota. For the Son of Man is not come to destroy men's lives but to save them.
Nitori omo eniyan ko wa lati pa emi eniyan run bi ko se lati gba ala.
It's a devil that wants to destroy.
Satani lo nfa panu.
But the Lord Jesus Christ has come.
Sugbon Jesus Christ Oluwa ti de.
So that he will save you.
Ki o ba le gba ola.
And tonight you will be saved.
Lale ya o gba ola.
If you have not been born again.
Ki o ko ba ti di
atobi. The life of Christ will come into you.
Iye Christ yo wa lo re.
A mighty change, a definite change will come upon your life in Jesus name.
Iyipada nla, iyipada pato yo de ba aye re ni oruko Jesu.
In John chapter 3.
Ninu John ori keta.
Verses 16 and 17.
Ese kan idinlogun ati keta
idinlogun. For God so loved the world.
Nitori Olorun fi araye to
be ge. That he gave his only begotten son.
Ti o fi omo bibi re kan so so fun
ni. That whosoever believes in him.
Ki ani keni ti o ba gbagbo.
Whosoever.
Ani keni.
The call is coming to you tonight.
Ito lo nto wa lale yi.
Whosoever.
Ani keni.
The love of God is reaching you tonight.
Ito Oluwa nto wa lale yi.
Whosoever.
Ani keni.
Believes in him.
Ti o ba gbagbo.
Shall not perish but have everlasting life.
Baba asegbe sugbon ko le ni iya ni peko.
For God has not sent a son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved.
Sugbon ki a le ti ipase re gba araye la.
The accounts written about the Lord Jesus Christ.
Akosile ta ko nipa ti Jesus Christ.
In Matthew, Mark, Luke and John.
Ninu Matthew, ninu Mark, Luke ati John.
All those accounts tell us of the mission of Christ among men.
Gbogbo akosile yi lo so fun wa nipa ise ti Jesus wa se laaye
ni. That is to say.
Eyi ni lati wi pe.
And tonight the Lord has come down here.
Lale yi Oluwa ti sokale.
He wants to save. He wants to heal. He wants to deliver. He wants to set free. He did it before. He
is
still doing it today. Because Christ is unchanging. His ministry is unchanging. His message is unchanging. His mission is unchanging. Look at the conclusion of it in John chapter 10 verse 10. John chapter 10. Ten verse 10. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Here is the announcement of Christ. There is the proclamation of Christ. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly.
Emi wa ki won le ni iye ani ki won le ni lopo lopo.
If you want life,
you ba fe iye,
you come to Christ.
O to Christ.
You want eternal life,
o fe iye ni
pe, you come to Christ.
O to Christ.
You want abundant life,
o fe iye lopo
lopo, you come to Christ.
O to Christ.
Christ remains the same.
Christ je okan na sibe.
He has not changed.
Ko yi pada.
The Bible affirms.
Bibe li fese re mule.
That Jesus Christ.
Pe Jesu Christi.
The same yesterday.
Okan na ni lana.
And today.
Ati loni.
And forever.
Ati titi lai.
If you will open the door of your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ tonight.
Ti o ba le sileku okan re paya fun Christ Oluwa lale
yi. He will forgive your sin.
Yo dari esere
jo. He will change your life.
Yo ye aye re pada.
And then he will remove every negative sin, every work of Satan away from your life tonight in Jesus name.
Leyin na ohun gbogbo to lodi ninu aye re. Gbogbo ise Satan ni yo mu kuro ninu aye re lale yi ni oruko Jesu.
I am convinced without any shadow of doubt.
O da mi loju lai si owu
ti Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Pe Jesu Christ okan na ni lana loni ati
titi. As he has done for other people in other places, he will do for you tonight in Jesus name.
Gege bi o ti se fun awon elomiran ni awon bomiran, yo se fun iwo na ni lale yi ni oruko Jesu.
And I've seen the Lord healing the sick.
Mo ti ri Oluwa to mu awon laisan
dada. I've seen the Lord opening the eyes of the blind.
Mo ti ri Oluwa to nlaju awon
afoju. Making the lame to rise up and walk. Making the deaf to hear. Making the dumb to speak. And removing infirmities from their lives. I am convinced that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. What he did for others, he will do for you today. Are you ready for it? I said, are you ready for it? Can you stand up on your feet? You want to meet Jesus Christ. You want to taste the goodness of the Lord. He has not come to condemn you. He has not come to judge you. He wants to cleanse you. He wants to purge you. He wants to renew your life. Anything in your life, he wants to forgive. He wants to give you eternal life. He wants to save you. Give him a chance to do it. Give him a chance to do it. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord in prayer. Say, Lord, I need you. Say, Lord, I want to be saved. Say, Lord, I want you to forgive my sin. Say, Lord, I want you to change my life. I believe. You are not condemning me. You are not judging me. You want to save me. That's his mission. That's his mission. And that's his message to you. That if you will repent and call upon the Lord, he will have mercy upon you. He will save you. He will forgive you. He will make you a child of God. In Jesus' name we pray. If you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ, you do not want to come to judgment on the final day. You want to receive him now as your savior. You want him to forgive your sin. And you are willing to repent so that eternal life will be yours. Wherever you are, you simply raise up your hand. And then I will be praying with you that the mercy of the Lord will reach you, that the forgiveness of the Lord will reach you, that the salvation of the Lord will be yours. Where are you? Can you raise up your hand? Can you raise up your hand? If you want the forgiveness of the Lord, raise it up very well. Keep it up as I'm going to pray with you now. Keep up your hand. All those who are raising up their hands, simply tell the Lord that you are sorry for the sin you have committed. You will not go back to those sins anymore. The adultery and the fornication, you will not go back to them anymore. The stealing and the fraud, repent, promise the Lord. You will not go back to them anymore. Amen.
Amen.
Keep up your hand now as I pray with you. Almighty God, we thank you because you are rich in mercy. Because of your abundant mercy manifested in Christ, I pray for all these signs of men, women, and children that are restored. Forgive all their sins in Jesus' name. Blot out all their transgressions in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, as you said, you have not come to condemn. I pray that all these with their hands raised up, they will not come to condemnation in Jesus' name. Give them peace in their mind. Assurance of their salvation. I pray, Lord, write their names in the book of life in Jesus' name. Give them the grace, give them the power to go and live a new life in Jesus' name.
ati agbara lati bere si gbegbe aye otun na ni
orukọ Jesu. Where they were weak before, make them strong in the Lord.
Nibi ti won ti je alailera tele so won di alagbara
ni Oluwa. They will manifest that new life in their communities where they live.
Ki won ko le ma fi igbe aye otun na ni adugbo ibi ti won gbe.
We bless your name because we know you have answered.
A fi ibukun fun orukọ yin nitori amọ pe ti da wa lohun.
In Jesus name we pray.
Ni orukọ Jesu ni agbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
We're ready to pray now for those who have any problem.
Báyìí a ti ṣetán láti gbàdúrà fún ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá ní ìṣòro kí
ìṣòro. Any sickness, any infirmity.
Àìsàn ká àìsàn, àìlera ká àìlera.
Whatever sickness it may be is the work of the devil.
Àìsàn yóò kí ìbàjẹ́ iṣẹ́ èṣù ni.
And you remember that Jesus Christ still has a ministry of miracles.
O sì rántí síbẹ̀ wípé Jésù Kristì Olúwa ní iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ ti iṣẹ́ ìyanu.
And the Lord is going to touch you tonight. You will be healed. You will be made whole in Jesus' name.
Olúwa yóò sì fi ọwọ́ kàn lálẹ́ yìí,
stand on our feet if you can. You will lay your hand on the place where you have the problem. Then you raise up the other hand. Then I will pray for you in the name of Jesus. After the prayer, you will check up yourself. The problems, the sicknesses, the infirmity you see there now, you will not see it again after the prayer.
Àìsàn, àìlera, ìdálóró èṣù tó rí níbẹ̀ báyìí, o ní rí níbẹ̀ mọ́ lẹ́yìn àdúrà yìí ní orúkọ Jésù.
Almighty God will come before you now.
Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè a wá síwájú yín báyìí.
You are a God that changes not.
Ẹjẹ́ Ọlọ́run tí kìí yí padà.
Lord Jesus, we magnify your name.
Jésù Olúwa gbé orúkọ yín ga.
You are Redeemer, Healer, and Deliverer.
Ẹ̀yin ni olùgbàlà olùrapadà àti olùwòsànlá, ẹ ò sì yí padà síbẹ̀.
Spirit of the living God.
Ẹ̀mí Ọlọ́run alàyè.
We welcome you here.
A kì yín káàbọ̀ sí.
You are the one that has power to quicken our mortal body.
Ẹ̀yin ló ní agbára láti sọ ara kíkú wá
dàrú. And the Holy Ghost has not changed.
Ẹ̀mí mímọ́ kò sì tí ì yí padà.
Therefore, Lord, welcome me before you now.
Nítorí ni Olúwa tọ̀ yín wá ní ìsinsìnyí.
Pray that unlimited, unchanging power will touch everyone now in Jesus' name.
À ń gbàdúrà wípé kí agbára yín tí kò ní òdiwọ̀n, tí kò sí lè yí padà kó fọwọ́ kan olúkúlùkù báyìí ní orúkọ Jésù.
That every plant the Heavenly Father has not planted in the body, in the life, in the family of all these people of God, all those plants will be uprooted immediately tonight in Jesus' name.
Pé gbogbo igi tí bàbá wa ti ń bẹ lọ́rùn kò gbìn sínú àgọ́ ara, sínú ẹbí, sínú ayé àwọn ènìyàn yìí. Gbogbo igi náà lẹ́ ó pàtó báyìí ní orúkọ Jésù.
That swelling in their body, I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo nǹkan wọn ni tó wú sí àgọ́ ara wọn, mo pàṣẹ fún ọ, jáde ní orúkọ Jésù.
Whether it is hernia or goiter.
Ibẹ̀ jẹ́ ìpáke ni tàbí gẹ̀gẹ́
ọ̀run. Tumor or hunchback.
Ìjú ni tàbí ike
yìí. Elephantiasis or fibroid.
Jakutẹ ẹsẹ̀ bíi tẹ́lẹ̀ ní
tàbí ìjú. I command you now, come out in Jesus' name.
Mo pàṣẹ fún ọ báyìí, jáde ní orúkọ Jésù.
All sicknesses and diseases in the body of anyone here.
Gbogbo ẹ̀yin àìsàn àti àrùn nínú àgọ́ ara ẹni
kẹ́ni. That tuberculosis in their body.
Ikọ́ jẹ̀dọ̀jẹ̀dọ̀ nínú àgọ́ ara ẹni.
The problem in the kidney.
Ìṣòro ti ń bẹ nínú kídìnrín.
The heart disease over there.
Àti àìsàn ti ń bẹ nínú
àgọ́ ara ẹni. The ulcer in their body.
Egbò tàbí ọgbẹ́ inú nínú àgọ́ ara wọn.
I command you right now, come out in Jesus' name.
Bẹ́yìí, mo pàṣẹ fún ọ. Jáde ní orúkọ Jésù.
The high blood pressure that is tormenting you.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ gbọ́dọ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ ríru ni tó ń
dá lóró. The asthma that is worrying that individual.
Ikọ́ afẹ́ tó yọ
ẹ̀yìn lẹ́nu. The pain in the body of that individual.
Ìrora ti bẹ nínú àgọ́ ara ẹni.
HIV or AIDS that is destroying the life and the body of that individual.
Àrùn kògbóògùn, àrùn AIDS tó yọ ẹ̀yìn lẹ́nu tó
pa àrùn. All those sicknesses, I command you, come out in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo ẹ̀yin àìsàn àti àrùn yìí mo pàṣẹ fún yín, ẹ jáde ní orúkọ Jésù.
The leprosy in your body and the skin disease.
Àrùn ẹ̀tẹ̀ nínú àgọ́ ara rẹ àti gbogbo kúrú náà.
The cleansed, be healed in Jesus' name.
Gba ìwòsàn, gba òmìnira ní orúkọ Jésù.
The disease of cancer.
Àìsàn tá ń pè ní àrùn jẹrẹjẹ
ògùn cancer. I command that cancer, dry up, be healed in Jesus' name.
And
those who have any problem with demonic spirit, that demon of insanity, that demon of epilepsy, all those evil personalities and moving objects, I command you now, you have no right to remain there. Get out in Jesus' name. Every yoke, every affliction, every curse, every attack caused by those evil powers, I break everything. I destroy everything. Be removed, be delivered in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are blind. I pray that your blind eyes, the Lord will touch you now.
You
spirit of blindness, come out in Jesus' name. Whatever is covering your eyesight, whatever is making it to be dim, I command that thing to be removed. Open your eyes, see clearly in Jesus' name. Short leg, withered hand, be made alive in Jesus' name. Every form of incurable disease, every form of terminal disease, every form of deformity in your body, I drive them out now. I stand against them now. Be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are jobless. I pray for those who are barren. I pray for those who have family problems. I pray for those who have hindrances to progress. Touch their lives. Touch their business. Touch their family. Remove the hindrances in Jesus' name. Lord, everyone here, I pray right now, your power and your might, your miracle, your supernatural power will touch everyone. As we close the prayer now, blind eyes to open, the lame to rise up and walk, the people that have eaten disease to be healed, insanity to be taken away, impossibility to be possible. Touch everyone. Touch everyone. Touch everyone. Deliver them and heal them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because I know it's done. I know it's done. I know it's done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.